What's up, guys? This is Coach Grant with First Down Training, and today we're going to be talking about how you wide receivers can beat a physical DB. I think the most important thing when going up against a physical DB is having a plan for your feet and for your upper body, guys. So we're going to break that down today, and the first one we got is DeAndre Hopkins here running this dig route. So the one thing I want you to focus on right here, I want you to focus on is his left shoulder, how he gives this shoulder lean. This is one of the best techniques to beat a physical DB off a double move or a split release. Let's watch this thing full speed one more time. So split release, dip that shoulder, restack him, give a stick to the inside, then get upfield. So he's coming off the line here. He gives this split release. Now, he does a good job of giving head and shoulder movement to the outside. But see, this DB's got a pretty good base right here. He's in a pretty strong position. And what's he going to try to do? He's going to try to get him. He's going to try to pop him with this outside hand. He's taking an inside release. So he knows all he has to do is beat this punch. He doesn't even have to worry about the right hand. So he comes off here. He jams with the left. As you can see, he's trying to attack that shoulder. He's trying to knock him off this platform. But again, another thing I want to stress, guys, DeAndre Hopkins is in a very explosive position, okay? His chest isn't up. He's not exposing his numbers. His head's not straight up where he's going to get knocked off this route. He's in an explosive position, and he dips that shoulder. What that does is that causes him to whiff. This DB whiffs. This is a very bad position for him to be in right now because DeAndre Hopkins is going full speed. He's still almost flat-footed with no hands on one of the best receivers in the NFL. It's a great job avoiding with his shoulder, and now he gets upfield, and he restacks him. Now he's chasing him on his back hip, makes a stick to the inside here, then comes out on this dig, snaps that head around, comes over the middle, and makes this catch. It's a great job using that shoulder dip technique off of a split release to get separation. And you could work this same technique. Let's say he goes just a double move right now. Let's say he just goes in, back out. Same thing. You could dip that shoulder to avoid this opposite punch. So this is when you would be taking an inside release. You want to work that shoulder lean, okay? Then same thing when you're working an outside release. If you're coming to an outside release, you want to dip this right shoulder. So maybe go out, then back in, dip the right shoulder, then take an outside release, okay? Let's watch this thing full speed one more time. In, out, dip the shoulder, get over the top, stick, come back over the middle. That's a great job. Okay, so now we're going to be breaking down Julio. Now, this is a double move. This is another technique you can do on a double move. Again, this DB is coming straight at him, trying to jam him with two hands here, trying to get hands on him. And watch, he does the slap chop technique. Again, I talk about it, having a plan for your feet and for your hands, guys. Let's watch this thing full speed one more time. So one, two, slap chop, lean into him. That's a great technique to use against a physical DB, and catch this ball and then get up the sideline. So main thing I want to focus about is he's going in, so in one, and then back out here too. A very explosive position with this foot, and I want you to see his pad level, guys. This is how you beat a physical DB. If he was standing up straight tall, he wouldn't be able to beat this DB in such an explosive position. He'd be able to pop him in the chest and get him knocked off this thing. So, again, he's taking an outside release, so he knows this right hand doesn't matter until it's a recovery, okay? So what does he do? Julio attacks the back. You can kind of see it right here. The back of his elbow, very explosive movement with his hand. Violent hand slap right here. This is a great angle. Slap and then chop him with the opposite arm. Chop. Get those hands off right here. Slap, chop. That's where we need to be, guys. Now, another thing I want you to notice is when he brings this right arm over to chop, he's not bringing this thing way over his head, or he's not trying to swim over the top here. What he's doing is he just chops straight down. He doesn't want to expose his rib cage right here, because what's this DB going to do? He's going to react with the right hand and pop him right in the rib cage. But if you keep this elbow tight and it's just nice and easy, slap, chop, that's all you have to do. You don't have to bring that thing way over your head, and he's got some separation. Now, see, he's trying to recover. Now, what does Julio do? He wants to sell this post by coming back to the inside here, looking back over his shoulder, and he initiates the contact. Sometimes physical DBs, guys, we've got to initiate the contact. We don't want to run away from contact. So he initiates this contact to get a little bit of a push off to him because he knows he's going out. Gets a little bit of a push off there. Receivers being physical, that's how we attack physical DBs. We need to be physical as a receiver if you're going to rather be the hammer or the nail. That's the mindset that you need to have off the line and in top of the route. So using this slap chop off of a double move, again, having a plan for both your feet and a plan for your hands, and then initiating the contact, not being afraid of the contact. Let's watch this thing full speed. So in, out, slap, chop, protect the rib cage, get a lean, a little bit of a push off, sudden stick, then catch this ball, then get upfield. Okay, so now there's another Julio Jones clip. He's going to be working a comeback and then go. So a double move, and this guy does a pretty good job of keeping hands on him throughout the whole entire route. Let's watch this thing full speed. Comes off a little bit of a slow play release, doesn't a good job of keeping hands on him. Gets him, though. Gets him with his eyes. Gets him with that push-off with that stick on a double move. You could work this on a stop-and-go as well, guys. So, comes off the line here. He's trying to get a read on him. He's trying to see how he's playing. He's gathering this information. He keeps a pretty good base right here, and now he's going to pop him with his hands. He's going to try to force him to the sideline. DB thinks he plays this very well. Gets his hands on him, and he's pushing him to the sideline. Here, good. That's a good job. Devy's in a good position. He's got hands on him. That's what you have to do when you're guarding a great receiver like Julio Jones, one of the best in the game. So now, he sinks his hips right here. He snaps down, sinks his hips, making this DB think that he's going to just be running a comeback and he's going to get out of this thing, okay? Now, he wants to undercut this thing and make a play. What does he do here? He sells this thing with his head and his shoulders to the inside to get this DB to look back for the ball, okay? He's got to have a little bit better eye discipline here, but it all comes from Julio Jones selling this thing with his upper half, giving his head and his shoulders to the comeback, making him think the comeback is coming. When it's a physical DB like that, he's very anxious to make a play, very anxious to make a play on the ball, and he doesn't do this slow turnaround right here. He puts this left foot in the ground and explodes up. Being explosive at the top of the route is a great way to be a physical DB. Gets him to overcommit. Now he's got his hands off of him, and this is a very, very bad position for this DB to be in, and he could burst upfield, high point that thing, and then make this catch in traffic. That's a great job by Julio Jones. Let's watch this thing full speed one more time. So kind of addresses him, comes off, he's got hands on him, sells this thing with his head and his shoulders, sudden stick, gets that DB off, beating a physical DB on a double move, guys. Okay, so now, this is going to be a great hand technique clip to study how we should attack this DB, how should we get his hands off. I know you hear a lot of guys say, oh, you want to get his hands off you. It's like, but how? How am I supposed to do that? What's the right technique? This is the right technique. So Keenan Allen's coming off, playing it pretty good, gets him in that blind spot to get into this route. So we got to have multiple ways to run a route, guys. You could run it. He could just get up into this route right now, make a stick, and then go into this out route, just put his foot in the ground, speed cut, and DB plays it. He's covered. But he doesn't want – you got to have multiple ways to run a different route. So one thing I want you to notice, he's got his hands on the inside of his arms right here, okay, guys? Now – his hips are fully committed to the sideline, so all he has to do is get his hands off of him, and there's going to be a huge blind spot right here, and this DB is going to be all turned around. So he comes off. Now, where does he attack? He doesn't worry about fighting those hands. He attacks the back of his elbow. That's a point of control. I learned that. I took a few jiu-jitsu classes a couple years ago, and they talked about occupying those points of control, your wrists, elbow. That's how you get his hands off right there. Attack that elbow, that behind, right behind that elbow. Now, this is a bad position. Now, here's that blind spot that I was talking about. All you got to do is get in this blind spot. He's going to snap his head around. He's going to try to speed turn out of there, and then we're off to the races to the outside. So that's exactly what he does. Gets his hands off of him, makes that stick here in this blind spot. Now his hips are backed over the middle, and we got to go outside. And even though he's making sure, he wants to swat him by right here with his other hand, like I talked about, having a plan for your upper half and a plan for your lower half. He makes this stick in the blind spot, makes him fall down, snaps that head around, and makes this catch, guys. That's how you execute proper hand technique, coming off this ball, hitting the back of his elbow, right behind that elbow, swat his hands off you, attack that blind spot, then sudden stick. Let's watch this thing full speed one more time. It's coming off the line, jab, back of the elbow, getting that blind spot, stick in the ground, speed cut, catch this ball. It's a great job. Okay, so now, one thing I want you to notice here is Davante Adams. I want you to look at his pad level and look at how fast he is with his hands. Okay, so let's watch this thing full speed. Get those hands off, and now he's got him beat, okay? So I don't think he gets the ball on this rep, but it's a good rep to explain how this DB's standing right here, good position, good base, and he's going to try to jam him with two hands right now. Now, Davante Adams here, I want you to notice how he's always real patient off the line because he wants to get a read on this DB, but he doesn't bring this pad level straight up. He doesn't bring the pad level up, and he's not super tall to where this DB could pop him off the line. He stays in this explosive position. I want you to see he's got a slight bend at his hips. He's got his chin. He's got his nose over his toes. That's an explosive position to be in. Now, see, this guy tries to pop him. Where does he go? His hand attacks right behind that elbow. Get those hands off. He keeps this opposite arm right here very tight, as you can see. He doesn't swing this shoulder up over the top. He keeps it very tight. He knows that this right arm right here, this DB, does not matter except on the recovery because he's trying to take an outside release. So if he just beats this left arm right here, he's going to get some separation. Now, yes, he recovered pretty well, but when you don't have hands on one of the best route runners in the game, that's going to be very tough. And Davante Adams knows it. He's throwing up his hand. He knows, I got him. If you run a comeback right here from this position, it's going to be very hard for him to react. You could run a dig and swat him by behind, or you could just try to keep going and burn him on a fade here. But that's a great job being quick with your hands, staying in a good pad level, and keeping that opposite arm very tight. Let's watch this thing full speed. So he takes a hesitation, jab, get him off. Attack the back of the shoulder. Okay, so now, this is Josh Norman and DeSean Jackson. Josh Norman is a very big DB, okay? I met him in person one time. He's about 6'3", great size for a defensive back. And DeSean Jackson's about 5'10". But he beats him on this route bad because of the range that he keeps. Let's watch this thing full speed one more time. So coming off here, sudden stick stays out of that range, and he burns him on this fade. We're going to watch it full speed in a second. So he's coming off here. Now, he's bailing out of there, but he knows he's the smaller guy. There's a size advantage. So what does he do? He wants to stay out of the range where Norman has to lunge at him if he wants to get hands. So he can work in this space right here. Now, this opposite arm, he lunges at him because, and then he's off balance, and then DeSean Jackson is able to just come off the outside right here. So see, lunges at him, and he stays out of this range. Stays in a great range right here, almost like a boxer. You hear the boxers talk a lot about their range. He stays out of that range. He's going full speed to the outside. Norman's turned to the inside. His hips opened up the wrong way, in my opinion, there. But he stayed out of the range. Guys, that's a great way to beat a physical DB. When you're the smaller guy, you stay out of that range. You work in space where he can't get hands on you, and he has to initiate contact and come at you. And that's a great ball from the quarterback over the top. Let's watch this thing full speed one more time. So coming off, stick to the inside, stay out of that range. And then we're off to the races, guys. Anytime we're facing a physical DB, a much bigger DB, size disadvantage for us, we got to be able to stay out of that range. Okay, so now this is the same thing. DeSean Jackson against his DB from the Patriots. He's going to be running a slant route right here. And I want you to see, again, much like the Devontae Adams clip we just broke down. So a little bit of a foot fire. Good pad level, swat those hands. I want you to see how quick his hands are, guys. You got to be working these drills before practice every single day, working fast hands, getting the DB's hands off you. So he's got active feet right here, trying to get a read on this guy, sees that he's flat-footed, and he's going to try to pop him with two hands right here. So, or pop him with the opposite hand, I'm sorry. So he does a pretty good pop right here, but I want you to see how quick the reaction is. How quick the reaction is from DeSean Jackson with his right arm. Swat that arm off. Be real violent with your hands. And now this is a bad position, especially on the goal line. When you don't have hands on one of the quickest receivers in the game, or on one of the quickest receivers in the game, you don't have hands on him in the red zone, maybe inside the five. That's a very bad thing right there. Just catch the ball. It's all the separation. A guy like DeSean go off the line here. And he gets popped, but he doesn't get knocked off of his route because of how explosive of a position he's in. Get that hand off fast with the right arm, and then let's get off to the races, and let's catch this slant for a touchdown. Let's watch this thing full speed one more time. So foot fire, get those hands off, snap that head back around. It's all the space we need, guys. Okay, so this is going to be a comeback route right here. This is from the Senior Bowl a few years ago. And this is going to be a great way to get rid of a physical DB downfield, okay? So let's watch this thing full speed, then we'll break it down. So coming upfield, get those hands off, coming off, catch this ball, okay? Now, a lot of people might think this is a flag, but the ball was not in the air yet, so this is just a great job of being physical. So he comes off this line here. He's selling this vertical. Anytime we got a physical DB, guys, we got to do everything right, okay? We got to do everything right. We got to sell like we're going fade. We got to make him believe fade that he's playing this thing good, and he's got hands on us. So what's another point of control? We talk about the back of the elbow, but what if we can't get the back of the elbow? In this position, he really can't get that back of the elbow, so he attacks the back of his shoulder, guys. That's another point of control. So we got the elbow just behind the elbow, maybe in some cases off the line, the forearm, and then the back of the shoulder downfield. Swat him by, get him committed upfield. This is a great job of selling the fade first. You sell the fade first, he's overcommitted. He's not going to be able to slow down. He doesn't know where we're breaking. We know where we're going. We know we're coming back down on this 45-degree angle. DB doesn't. DB doesn't know where the break's coming. So if we can get his hands off of us, he's not going to be able to react. We accelerate out of this break, and we make a catch. That's another great example of how to beat a physical DB. Let's watch this thing full speed one more time. Coming off the line, upfield, swat the back of the shoulder, in and out of this break, catch this ball for a great job. All right, guys, I really want to thank you for watching. I really appreciate it, guys. Please leave in the comments any questions you might have, any concerns, and ideas for my next video. I'd really appreciate that, and I'll see you guys next time.